couple weeks ago, I sat down and I typed in this question: Lord, do you have anything you could say to me about a person who lived in the past? I thought that if the Lord would tell me something that I don't already know, then I could search historical records and confirm if the message I'm being given is true. So after I typed in this question, I waited for just a moment, and then these words came to my mind. William Penn. And I paused while typing this, and I wondered, is that with two N's? And I thought, yes, it must be with two N's. Then I continued to type, was one of my own. William Penn was one of my own. And that was it. I thought, who is William Penn? I remember hearing that name many years ago in some history class, something to do with the United States early history, but I couldn't remember who he was. And then I wondered, well, maybe I could search the internet and find out about it. Is it possible that he belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ? Was he a devoted man of God? So I searched the internet, and, well, first I went to Wikipedia. Here I learned that William Penn was alive in the 1600s and into the early 1700s. He was a Quaker, so he was a Christian, and he was the founder of the province of Pennsylvania. Since his last name is Penn, I assumed that Pennsylvania was named after him. Pennsylvania, maybe. Sounds like it. And also, I learned something which I find very significant. Under his direction, the city of Philadelphia was planned and developed. Philadelphia is the only church named in the book of Revelation that is given a promise, a specific promise from our Lord. And the promise is, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. There are seven churches listed in the book of Revelation, and only Philadelphia has that distinction. I did a little bit more searching and found this book that William Penn wrote called No Cross, No Crown. Check out the view count, 777. There are no coincidences. I downloaded the book, which is freely available online, and I read through some of it, and I came to the conclusion that William Penn, that he was very devoted to God. He was not a lukewarm Christian. He wrote about the cross, the denial of self, and daily bearing of Christ's cross is the alone way to the rest and kingdom of God. And he quotes this verse from the book of Luke. And Jesus said unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. And he quotes a verse from 2 Timothy. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness. I was really excited when I found this information about William Penn, because I didn't know he was a Christian, and I didn't know he wrote a Christian book, and I would not have even thought to look for him on the internet if I had not received this message, which I now believe was the Lord telling me this. William Penn was one of my own. So then I prayed and I asked the Lord, would you like me to make a video about this? And then yesterday, I was not even thinking about William Penn, but I just looked on the internet for some news. I went to christiannews.net and I saw this article, "Atheists Seek Removal of Pennsylvania Bench That Features God," quote from state founder. Who is the state founder of Pennsylvania? It's William Penn. And here's something that he said. William Penn said this: "Men who aren't governed by God will be governed by tyrants."
Knock on some doors for me.
Knock on doors with me.
And make some calls for me.
And make phone calls with me.
If you are willing to work with me.
If you're willing to work even harder in this election.
Then I promise you.
Then I promise you.
I promise you change will come.
Oh yeah, here we go. It says it's paraphrasing a quote that is often attributed to Pennsylvania founder William Penn, a Quaker who wrote a number of theological books and who once stood trial for causing a tumult and preaching in the streets. I read that he did go to prison about 9 months. I like this. "No one has ever been forced to look at or use the bench." Now, why would people be so upset? They hate God. If people hate God, they're going to want to remove anything that reminds them about God. And that's really sad because God loves them. God loves atheists too. He also died for the atheists. If they would just turn away from their sins and turn toward Him, He could save them.